Hey guys, it's Jenna. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. So I'm back with another book video. It's gonna be a quick one. It's just a wrap-up. I'm gonna be sharing with you guys the books that I read for two readathons that I participated in the month of April. So I participated in the First Friday Readathon hosted by Rustic Pages on Instagram and Discovered Reads on Instagram, and the Staying Home Reading Rush, which I don't know as much about. I am just gonna share with you guys the books that I read. And I'm just going to do a quick little review of them, not really say that much about them, kind of similar to my other wrap-ups that I've done. Just because I don't want to spoil anything, or I just don't want to make this too long or boring of a video. And I can ramble and lose my train of thought, and it's not good. It'll get very confusing. We're going to start with the first book that I read and then go on like that. So, the first book I read is Swing by Cram Alexander. This was about just a guy who likes his best friend, but she doesn't like him back, and he is having a hard time admitting his crush. The only person who knows about it is his other best friend, and we kind of just go on this journey with him on him trying to confess his love for his best friend. It was written in poems, like all of Cram Alexander's books are, and it was okay. I like his books because they're fast and easy to read, but I don't always love the plot, and this is one where I didn't love the plot. I think I gave this about 3 stars out of 5. If you're trying to get out of a reading slump, I would recommend Cram Alexander's books. Maybe not this one, but one of Cram Alexander's. It was okay. We'll say that. Next, I read an audiobook. I read Lauren Graham's book, From Gilmore Girls to Gilmore Girls, Talking as Fast as I Can. And I read it on audiobook, which I really enjoyed because it was Lauren Graham narrating, and I really liked that. It really added to the story. But the problem with audiobooks is that it's so hard to stay into the story, because usually if you're reading an audiobook, you're also doing something, because you're not just going to sit there and just listen to the audiobook. So like, I went on a walk, or I was doing a puzzle. I also was having my mind on other things, so I was kind of listening to it but also having other thoughts, and it was a great book, but it was hard to stay in the story. But that's just me. I don't know if that's anyone else. I really enjoyed this book. I really like Lauren Graham and her acting and the show Gilmore Girls and the reboot, so I really enjoyed listening to the story. So the next book I read was Sundays at Tiffany's by James Patterson, which I think is one of my new favorites. I really, really enjoyed this book, and I thought it was such a cute story, and I flew through it. It's about this girl named Jane Margot, who has this imaginary friend, and she's with him at the beginning of the story when she's a young girl, but then he leaves, and when she's in her 30s, he comes back and they reunite. So it's a really, really cute story, and I really liked it. I honestly would recommend this, but I saw the trailer for the movie and probably won't be watching it because it did not look good. It did not look the same, so I probably won't be watching that, but I would love to reread this. Like, I would reread this if I didn't have other books I had to read on my TBR. Next up, for the next readathon, I read Les Miserables, the adaptation by Monica Culling. This was for 3 of the prompts for the Staying Home Reading Rush. It was for the read a book with a house on the cover, read a book that makes you smile, and read a book that you can read in one sitting. I'm sure you know what Les Miserables is about, but if you don't, it's about a guy named Jean Valjean, who is a convict on the run and promises to take care of Cosette, a poor orphan girl, but Paris police are hot on his trail, and it just goes through his journey. This is definitely the very, very short version of the very long book. I don't know what I've rated that either, because I'm not sure if I gave that book a rating. I've been really slacking on my giving ratings on Goodreads. The last book up for this haul is Firefly Lane by Kristen Hanna. I read this for the other prompt, read a book set in a place you want to go. It's set in Washington, I believe. I don't really want to go there, but this is a book about two best friends in college, and I'm always dreaming about just being in college with my best friend, or like moving on with their lives in out of quarantine. I would love to be with my best friend right now, but I can't, so I just thought this would count. It's definitely a little risky because it might not be what the prompt really means, but we're gonna go with it. Firefly Lane is about Kate Mularkey and Tully Hart, and it starts out when they're around middle school age and they really meet for the first time as neighbors. And then the story continues, so they're senior in high school, they're in college, they're out of college, and then they're in like their 40s. It basically really takes them through their life. I feel like a point that really hit was more towards the end of the book, although it's all a blur for me. This book was just not that interesting, and I feel like if this was a different genre, like maybe if it was a mystery or something, then that would be very interesting. There were definitely parts where I was like, yeah, I don't care. I could just skip this part. There were parts where I was like, I really want to DNF this book. There were parts where I just didn't even read for days. Like, I just did not read this book for a long time. It took me almost a month to read this book. I started reading this book after the first Friday Readathon, which ended on the first Sunday of April. And I only just finished this a few days ago, and it is now April 25th. So yeah, it took me a long time to finish this book, and it's the first book that's taken me a long time to read in a while. Yeah, I probably would not pick up another Kristen Hannah book, even though The Nightingale by her is very popular. I just did not really enjoy this book at all. Maybe as a TV show or movie, but the story, the plot was not very interesting. So yeah, that's everything I read basically for the month of April, besides one other book that I'm in the middle of. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you're notified whenever I upload a new video. And also comment down below any book suggestions, recommendations that you guys have for me, or any books that you read for the month of April, or for any of these readathons if you participated in them. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!